In this illustration, we'll analyze a case when there is no effect of temperature on a composite rod. We are given that two rods of copper and steel are of equal cross section and are joined to form a composite rod of length 2 meter. The length of copper rod is 0.5 meter. It is given that when the temperature is raised from 20 to 120 degree centigrade, the length of composite rod increases to 2.002 meter. Now it is saying the composite rod is fixed between two rigid walls at 20 degrees centigrade, and it is found that length of the two rods do not change with temperature, and we are required to calculate the Young modulus of steel if that of copper is this, and coefficient of linear expansion of copper is also given to us. Now in this situation, here we can analyze as length of copper rod is 0.5 meter, this implies the length of steel rod will be 1.5 meter. And here we can write initially total expansion of rod is, if we just say when it is raised from 20 to 120 degree, total expansion is 0.002 meters. So we can write delta L is equals to delta L of copper plus delta L of steel. So in this situation, this 0.002 is equals to increase in length of copper can be written as alpha copper length of copper multiplied by delta T. And delta L of steel can be written as alpha steel length of steel multiplied by delta T. So if we substitute here, the length of copper rod is 0.5 meter multiplied by alpha of copper multiplied by 100, plus this is 1.5 multiplied by alpha of steel multiplied by 100. Here, if we substitute the value of alpha copper, which is already given to us, this will give us the value of alpha steel. Once you substitute the value of alpha copper and you numerically calculate, we'll get the value of alpha steel as 0.8 multiplied by 10 to power minus 5 per degree centigrade. So here we have got the value of coefficient of linear expansion of steel and that of copper, which was already given to us. Now it is saying that after placing the composite rod between walls, as we are given that the length of the rods do not change with temperature, so we can write here we use thermal expansion in each rod is compensated by elastic strain, or which is the elastic compression in rod, in that particular rod, we can say. So here we can simply write that stress in any rod is Young modulus multiplied by strain in the rod. So here we can write as stress is Young modulus multiplied by strain. In this case, we can write a stress in the copper rod must be equal to the stress in steel rod, because both are joined end to end. If we substitute the value of stress as Young modulus of copper multiplied by strain in copper, will be the thermal expansion of the rod, which can be written as delta L by L, which we can write as 0.5 multiplied by alpha of copper multiplied by delta T divided by 0.5. So this 0.5 gets cancelled out. This equals to Young modulus of steel multiplied by the strain in steel is 1.5 multiplied by alpha of steel multiplied by delta T divided by length, which is 1.5, that also gets cancelled out. Here delta t will also get cancelled out. So, this gives us the Young modulus of steel as Young modulus of copper multiplied by alpha of copper divided by alpha of steel. So, we substitute the values. Young modulus of copper is given to us 1.3 into 10 to power 13 multiplied by alpha of copper is 1.6 into 10 to power minus 5 divided by the 0.8 multiplied by 10 to power minus 5. We already calculated. So, solving this numerically, we get 2.6 into 10 to power 13 newton per meter square. That is the result of this problem.